Hello guys, welcome to Maths Marathon. So now the last part of similar triangles from class 10 mathematics. Okay, these problems are very, very important and they'll help you in preparing for examinations to score like 100% marks, right? And all the problems are the one which are extracted from previous papers as well as the other important problems from other kinds of examinations. So pay attention and try to grab the benefits of this video. Right now, in figure triangle ABC, D is parallel to BC, right? And these two are given to be parallel. AD is equal to 1.5. This is 1.5. DB is equal to 6. That means it is 4 times. You can say that it is 1:4 ratio. This side D is dividing AB in 1:4 ratio. And now EC is equal to, EC is 8, and here then what is this one, what is X here? So X is AE. So now X:8 is equal to 1:4, right? So that means it is X is equal to 2. In ABC triangle, if X and Y are points on AB and AC respectively, so let's draw a triangle first. This is ABC triangle. X and Y are points on A and AB and AC respectively, such that AX by, so this is X, this is Y, AX by XB, this ratio is given to be 3:4. And AY is equal to 5, this is 5, and YC is equal to 9, right? AX by XB is 3/4, AY is equal to, then state whether XY and BC are parallel. See, for this line XY to be parallel to BC, the condition is that the ratios must be equal. Now, what is the ratio given here? 5/9. So now 3/4 is not equal to 5/9 at any cost, right? So therefore, they are not parallel. Therefore, XY is not parallel to ABC, right? So this is the solution for this problem, right? So now, those who have not watched the previous videos of similar triangles, please watch those two also, so that you will get the complete knowledge of which theorem we are using, how we are using, why we are coming to these conclusions. Right, in the given figure triangle ABC, right, this triangle is similar to PQR, find the value of Y plus Z. Okay, so now we use the similarity conditions here. Here itself I can finish it off. So, I don't know Y and Z. So, therefore, once to find out Y, I use those values which are known to us. So, Y by 4 root 3 is equal to, the remaining steps you can write, right? So, since they are similar, BC by QR is equal to AC by PR, right? So, BC by QR is equal to AC by PR. So, therefore, Y/4√3 is equal to 6/8. Okay. So, now it is 4 2s are 2 3s are. So, Y is equal to 3√3. We got Y value to be equal to 3√3. So, similarly, find out Z. So, the term involving Z and the known values. So, therefore, now what is the other statement? AB by PB is equal to, which is involving Z, is equal to AC by PR again, because both are known values to us. So 3/Z is equal to 6/8. So 3 2s are 2 4s are, therefore Z is equal to 4. So we got Y value to be 3√3 and Z value to be 4. So Y plus Z is equal to 3√3 + 4. Y plus Z is equal to 3√3 + 4. Clear? Right. So then now let's move on to the next one. I think this one you can solve by yourself. The same condition you are going to use 6 by 8 is equal to 3 by 2 plus n. And similarly 6 by 8 is equal to y by 4 root 3 as how we have taken this. Right. So now the next one is construct a triangle of sides. So this is construction part. The first video on similar triangles was based on constructions only. That means we covered the construction models. So just watch the video and try to construct yourself so that it gives you a better practice for the examination. So the next one, ABC is a right angled triangle, right angled at C. Let BC is equal to A, CA is equal to B, AB is equal to C, and let P be the length of the perpendicular from C on AB. Prove that PC is equal to AB. So 1 minus B square. First of all, let us draw the diagram. So what is given? ABC is a triangle is given. Right? And he said that a right angle is at C. So right angle is at C and the AC is equal to B, CB is equal to A and AB is equal to C, small c, small c. Don't get confused with this capital C to small c, right? So now what is the other one he said? Like, so the perpendicular drawn from C on to AB, like that the base is D. Clear? So now what we need to prove is PC is equal to AB. PC is equal to AB. This is P multiplied by C. That means height multiplied by base. If I take the triangle like this, like if I just turn the triangle like this, this will become the base, this will become the height. So this base into height here is equal to AB. Base into height, if I take the triangle like this, that's all. It's only the thing is that you need to imagine the triangle to be like this. Okay, right. So therefore now you have the area of triangle ABC. We have half A into B as AC into A, base into height is equal to half base is your C into height is P. So therefore half of will get cancelled. AB is equal to CP. So what are the statements that you need to write is like this. So now CD is perpendicular to AB. Therefore area of triangle ABC is equal to half CD into AB. Write done. Equation 1. And but AC is perpendicular to CB. Already we can see that. Therefore area of the triangle is equal to half AB. So therefore from the 1 and 2, so let us name this as 1 and this as 2. So from 1 and 2 area of triangle will be the same. So therefore PC is equal to BA, hence proved. So these are the steps that you need to maintain. But before you proceed to solve step by step, please in similar triangles, first of all, in which direction we need to approach to the solution, that is important. So as immediately as you look at the diagram, you should get an idea as how we got it now. P into C, what is P? This is P, this is C. So that means if I just rotate the triangle in this manner, this becomes the base, this becomes the height. And in the regular manner how it is, this is the base, this is the height. Obviously, area can be measured either like this or even like this area can be measured. So, if you get that idea, just write it in the margin and then proceed to prove this. Right? Because steps are also important. Getting idea. So, if this is only an objective question, writing just like this is enough. But when it is given for 4-mark question, you are supposed to write all the steps. So please pause the video for a moment and then note down all the steps. Now in the second part of the same problem. So to understand the problem, let us draw the triangle again. Okay. Yet C you have 90 degrees. And from C, you are drawing a perpendicular CD, capital C, right? And this is 90 degrees. And you have this to be ABC, suppose, right? BC is A. And this is B. I think this is ABC. Let us verify how it is. AB square is equal to AC. AC is right. BA, right, and then next D, right. So this whole thing is a small c. So this is a triangle for us, right. So now, what is that? 1 by p square is equal to 1 by a square plus 1 by b square. There is a correction. Plus 1 by b square. So, we can use, because squares are there, we can use Pythagoras theorem. Yes, by using Pythagoras theorem, you have this as a hypotenuse, that is ib square is equal to ac square plus cb square, which is a square plus b square. But already you have ab is equal to cp, just now we proved, is it not? So, therefore, in place of c, you can write ab by p whole square, which is a square plus b square. So, now, a square b square by p square is equal to a square plus b square. Just bring it here because we want in denominator a square and b square values. So, therefore, on cross multiplication, you will get this one here. And now, if you split this one, split the numerator as a square by a square plus b square by a square plus b square. Now, here in the term, a square will get cancelled, b square. So, 1 by p square is equal to 1 by b square plus 1 by a square, hence proved. Okay, so this is how we are going to prove this one. Right, just pause the video and then try to note it down. Steps are very important, even the reason why you are taking that is also important. Now let us see the next problem, 27th one. Express x in terms of a, b and c in the given figure. Right, so let us observe the figure how it is. Right, this is 46 degrees, that means these two are parallel, absolutely it is understood. Okay, right, so therefore this triangle, that is triangle MLK, is similar to triangle NPK, right? Yes. So now when they are similar, we have ratios of the corresponding sides to be equal. So now here the problem is to find out x. Okay, so we will take the side which is involved with x. So x by a, this is base by base, right? So is equal to, right, now C by, right, C, this side is C by the whole side of the bigger triangle, that is B plus C, B plus C. So, therefore, X is equal to AC by B plus C. So, this is the right option. Right, if the sides of triangle are 3 cm, 4 cm and 6 cm long, determine whether the triangle is right angled or not. See, the children, those who know it directly, that the right angle, that is Pythagoras triplet, will be 3, 4, 5. It is understood that when it is 6 cm, then definitely this is not right angled triangle. But this is not with multiple choice question. That means it is not an objective question. We are supposed to solve it. So, if it is Pythagoras theorem, it is supposed to be like bigger side, whatever bigger side is, the square of that should be equal to sum of the squares of this thing, right? So now therefore square of biggest side or longest side is 36. Now sum of the squares of other sides is equal to, right, 3 square plus 4 square, 9 plus 16, which is equal to 25. Let this be equation 1 and this is equation 2. So, like 1 is not equal to 2, implies it is not right angle triangle. Right angle triangle. Right, so that is how you have to write all the statements. You can write it by yourself, but this is the concept. Right, so first of all, you have to find out the square of the longest side. And then sum of the squares of the shortest side. Now you should write according to Pythagoras theorem, 1 should be equal to 2. If they are not equal, then it is not right angle triangle. Right. So next one. In triangle ABC, DE is parallel to BC. Right, DE is parallel to BC. That means DEA, triangle DEA is similar to BCA. Clear? Right. So therefore RADE is similar to ABC. Okay. AD is given to be X. Let us write it as X. DB is given to be X minus 2. Okay. Now AE is X plus 2 and EC is X minus 1. Find the value of X. Okay, find the value of x. So first of all, let us see directly x by x minus 2, because equal ratios parallel line will divide. So x plus 2 by x minus 1. Right, so now let us simplify. This is x square minus x upon cross multiplication, which is equal to x plus 2 into x minus 2. That is x square minus 4. That is a plus b into a minus b is a square minus b square. So here x square will get cancelled. Minus minus will get cancelled. Therefore x is equal to 4. Very simple problem. Straight problem. Right. Now the 30th problem. O is any point inside a rectangle ABCD. Prove that OB square plus OD square is equal to OA square plus OC square. So O is the point inside the rectangle ABCD. Let's see how to solve this one. Right. So now take a triangle rectangle ABCD. Right. Let O be the point inside. Right. And then now AO, OB, OD, OC. Right. So what is that we need to prove? Right. We need to prove that I am writing it here. OB square plus OD square is equal to OA square plus OC square. Remember, whenever it is in similar triangles with squares, absolutely you have to go with Pythagoras theorem. There will be a chance for you to use Pythagoras theorem, or rather this is a hint to use Pythagoras theorem. So to make that one possible, just draw a line passing through O such that it drops a perpendicular on AB as well as DC. That means OP is perpendicular to AB and OQ is perpendicular to DC. Now this is how we drew it. Now observe very carefully. We want OB square. OB square means PB square plus PO square, is it not? Yes, perfect. But PB square is equal to QC square or not? Yes, perfectly right. Right, so like this you need to see the possibilities and then find out OB square plus OD square is equal to OA square plus OC square. That means four right angle triangles we are going to use, four Pythagoras theorem statement equations, and then rearranging the terms we get it, right? So therefore now we have already OD square is equal to OQ square plus QD square. OB square also you write down, right? Similarly, OA square also you write down. So all OB square, OA square, OD square and OC square are values. All values you write it down. Then afterwards try to equate QC is equal to PB and PA is equal to QD. So that we will get the required equations, right? So now we got adding 1 and 2, we got OB square plus OD square is equal to BP square plus OP square plus OQ square plus OD square. Right. So this is what we got, like based on all the four equations when you add OB square plus OD square. Clear? Right. Now in place of BP, because the same rectangle is here also, so that it will be easy for you to understand. BP is equal to CQ. So in place of BP, you are writing CQ square. Right. So similarly, QD, whatever QD is there, we are going to write it in EAP square. Right. So AP square. So that you will be getting CQ square plus OQ square, which is OC square. CQ square plus OQ square will give you OC square, will give you OC square. And the remaining two, that is OP square plus AP square. Right. OP square plus AP square gives you AO square. These two terms together, AO square. Finished. OB square plus OD square is equal to OA square plus OC square. Hence proved. So this is how you have to use your knowledge of Pythagoras theorem. Right. And to make it possible, just what is the additional thing we are doing? Only thing is draw perpendicular, right, passing through O such that P and Q are the points which are dividing AB in like perpendicular to AB, right? So that's all. If you make that imagination, it's absolutely perfect that you will be able to solve this question. Okay, so pause the video for a moment and note it down. So now let's see the next one. Right, so almost all theory questions only we have now. So fatafat we'll finish it off so that we can complete similar triangles. Children, I am repeatedly saying only one thing. Similar triangles demands a little bit of imagination, right? And you should be able to visualize in which direction if you proceed, you will be able to get the solution. Right, without this one, you will not be able to solve similar triangles. So, every problem, whatever is covered in these videos, again do it by yourself without copying the solution. So, then at that time, you will be getting the idea how to solve it. Right, to get the idea, please don't forget to watch the videos. But after watching the videos, close your whatever the work you have copied and start solving the problems by yourself using the techniques, right? Now, to divide a line segment AB in the ratio 4:7, so we have that concept of constructions. So there is a line segment AB, right? Now to divide this one in 4:7 ratio, let us suppose that it is in 4:7. Here AX is drawn making an acute angle here. This is construction part, right? So this is X, right? Drawn first such that BAX, right? BAX angle is an acute angle. Then points, right? A1, A2, A3 are located at equal distances on the ray. So now whenever the line segment has to be divided, the total line segment has to be divided into 4 plus 7, total 11 parts. So therefore this line, whichever you are drawing it here, will be divided into 11 parts. Like A1, A2, A3, so on till A11, right? So this is how you will divide it into 11 parts, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4, like that A11, okay? Now the point is on, right, and B is joined to, B is the end point, has to be joined to the last point on the line segment, whatever a line whatever we have drawn here. So that means it is going to join with A11. So B is the correct answer. So this concept is there in the first video of similar triangles in Maths Marathon, right? So now ABC, triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF, right? Now that means AB by DE is equal to, right, AC by DF is equal to BC by EF. Just like that I am writing, because these are similar triangles means the sides are proportional, right? Now AB is given, DE is given, EF is given and FD is given, right? So then find the perimeter of triangle ABC, right? So therefore find the triangle AB is given. Okay, we know AB, right? DE is given, we know DE. EF is given, we know EF. And FD is given, we know FD. Right, use these two, my dear students, because AB, DE, DF are known. You can find out AC, right? And use these two again, right? You will be able to find out BC. So, AB is already there. Find AC, find BC. Find the perimeter as AB plus AC plus BC, right? Very simple and straight problem, right? In a given figure, if ADE is perpendicular to BC, prove that AB square plus CD square is equal to BD square plus AC square. Okay, right. So what is that? Let us try to do this one now. See, I already said that whenever squares are there, that means you are going to use Pythagoras theorem. So now AB square you can find out. like as how we did the previous one. One more problem, we got it just like that, right? So AB square you have to find out, AC square you have to find out, right? And BC square you have to find out using Pythagoras theorem. So AB square, right? Now from AB square you can find out AD square. Now AC square, from AC square you can find AD square again, because in AC square also you'll get AD square plus DC square. In AB square also you'll get AD square plus DB square. So in both the cases you'll be getting AD square value. That means you got these two to be equal. That is AB square minus BD square is equal to AC square minus DC square. Rearranging the terms, you got the answer. Right? So how do you rearrange that? These two are equal. So AB square minus BD square is equal to AC square minus DC square. So what is the problem given? Problem is AB square plus CD square is equal to AB square plus CD square is equal to, right? Arranging the terms, AC square plus BD square. Hence proved. This is what we have to prove. We proved it. Right? So always remember one hint, that whenever there are square terms in case of similar triangles, somehow or the other you are going to use Pythagoras theorem. That means you need to look for 90 degrees. That is very, very important. Okay? So now the next one, 34. Construct a triangle. This is again a construction problem. You can refer to the first video. Right, when we construct a triangle similar to a given triangle as per the given scale factor, that means how, what are you doing? First you are constructing a big triangle, then acute angle you are taking, then in which ratio you have to divide, right? So that means suppose it is in 3 by 4 size, right? 3 by 4 size means the total line should be of 4 parts, right? And with the third part, whatever is there, you will be drawing a parallel to this one. And again a parallel to this one, right? So why we are doing it so? That means each side should be like 3/4 of the main triangle side. That means you are using side similarity, no doubt in that, as well as a line which is drawn parallel to a side, right? Parallel to a side always divides a triangle into a similar triangle here, and the bigger triangle is also similar. That means basic proportionality theorem also you are using. So therefore SSS similarity is there, BPT theorem is also there. Therefore D is the right answer. D is the right answer because A and C are correct. Right. So this one also you have ABC proportion similar to DEF, such that use the ratio of sides are equal concept and find out EF, right? So now the next one, that is 37th problem. PQR is a triangle right angled at P and M is a point on QR such that PM is perpendicular to QR. Show that PM square is equal to QM into MR. Right, so therefore here you will be drawing a triangle here, right angle triangle, right angle at P. Now draw up a perpendicular PM on QR, right? So that, see, again in this one, PM square. So I said whenever it is square term, remember to use Pythagoras theorem. So if you use Pythagoras theorem, so QR square is equal to PQ square plus PR square. But QR is equal to QM plus MR whole square. So I am giving you the rough structure. QR square is equal to PQ square plus PR square, right? But what is QR is equal to? QM plus MR. QM plus MR whole square is equal to PQ square plus PR square. Okay, fine. PQ square plus PR square. Now what is QM plus MR whole square? QM square plus MR square. This is A plus B. Whole square formula, 2QM into MR, because why we need to prove is we need QM into MR. We need QM into MR. That is why we are using this process. So PQ square plus PR square, right? So therefore now we need, what we need is PM square. We need this one. So now QM square, what is QM square? QM square can be written as PQ square minus PM square. Similarly, MR square can be written as PR square minus PM square. So that PQ square, PR square will get cancelled here and you will be left with 2PM square is equal to 2QM into MR and 2 will get cancelled. This is a rough idea. Right, writing the steps you need to write in detail like this. Okay. So why these two are similar triangles? You know it like basically that whenever a line is drawn or from the 90 degree vertex to the hypotenuse, making an angle 90 degrees on that, then this is going to divide the triangle into two similar triangles. They are similar to each other as well as they are similar to the bigger triangle also. Right? So, but here as far as I know, there is no need for you to say that they are similar because we are only using the diagram here. So, it is 90 degrees is given. This is 90 degrees is given. Now, we can use everything from Pythagoras theorem. There is no need for you to mention it. If you mention also, there is no harm. Okay, so like that you have to write the steps. Those who want the steps, please pause the video and try to note down the steps. Right, so now let's move on to the next problem. In the figure, DE is parallel to BC. Right, now you know very well. Right, AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. Is it there? Yes, it is there. Done, finished. Right, now explain about AA similarity between two triangles. See, what is AA similarity? If suppose we have AAA criterion, right, the corollary or the special case of AAA criterion is that there is no need for us to verify that three angles are equal in the two given triangles. But if you can prove that two angles, two corresponding angles are equal, then that is enough. It implies that both the triangles are similar. So that is called AA similarity. Right. Now two triangles satisfy the condition SAS, law of similarity. Draw their rough diagrams. See, yes, yeah, yes means I should have like this is some side A, B, C is here. Right, if this angle. Now, if I say P, Q, R. Right, so P, Q, R. Then this angle should be equal to this one, first condition. That means A condition. Now, this side AC should be proportional to PR. And that means AC by PR must be equal to AB by PQ. Right? So, AC by PR must be equal to AB by PQ. Then it means that it is SAS similarity. Okay? So, I can write it like this also. Because it's only an example, I can do that one. Okay? Right. So, now the last one. 654 are the sides and similarity is given here. 4 3s are 12 is here. So 6 3s are 18 comes here, 15 here. Find the perimeter of the second one. Sum of all these is 45. So done. All the best students. Try to do solve similar triangles problems by yourself. It is going to help you a lot. And I again suggest you, if you are not so good at drawing and using compass and all those things, and if you think that you consume more time in that, try to leave the construction problems in choice questions. But learn the steps of construction as well as the procedure and practice also at home, so that if it has become compulsory to for you to answer that question, you will be able to answer that one. Right, so if not, just you leave it as a choice. So see you again with another chapter. Dear students, this is the beginning of slideshow. Sheet 1, you can take the screenshot and take the printout also, or you can just look at the screen and solve the problems by yourself.
sheet 2. I'll give a few seconds to take the screenshot. Sheet 3, sheet 4, sheet 5, sheet 6, sheet 7, sheet 8. Altogether there are 41 problems. So as I said, try to solve yourself, like after watching the complete thing and getting the concept, try to solve yourself. It's going to help you a lot in your examination. Thank you for watching.